Hello lovely people, it's your girl Gloria, and welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about renting a house in the United Kingdom. Now, a lot of people have been asking me how can I get a house when I'm in the UK or when I'm outside the UK. Basically, I would say when you're outside the UK, it's kind of a little bit tricky to rent a house when you're not yet in the country, because most landlords, they don't know you, they don't know if you can afford their rent, they don't know if they can trust you with your house, because they don't know if you've got an employer and the rest of it. But I think it's possible if you can maybe get an employer to write a reference letter for you. If you can get an employer to write a reference letter for you, that would be very great, because even when you get a house, you still need the reference letter. But aside that, generally speaking, even before you get into the country, you can do your research. Search where you want to stay. You might have known where your work is located, or wherever it is you decide to stay, check the cost of living. Go site and search, compare price, compare the rent in various areas. There are places where things are cheaper, accommodation are cheaper. Places like Northern Ireland, accommodation is cheaper. Scotland, some other areas. London is the most expensive. You can stay like this. Oh God, it's really, really expensive out there. So you have to be sure of where you want to stay. You want to be sure of, you want to know what type of house accommodation you want, because there are different type of accommodation. There's the share, room share. That is when you're in a room in somebody else's flat. Like someone can have a 5-bedroom flat and you're taking one of their rooms. So that is a room share. You're going to be living in their room, in their house. Sharing the same, maybe the same sitting room, the same kitchen. You may have your bathroom, or you may not have your bathroom and your toilet, or you may share. Some may be in suit, that is, the toilet is in the room. So it depends on what you want, what you're looking for, what you want to stay. It can be the first time you're coming, you want to stay in the B&B. B&B, it's some other people also, they open their house for people to come and live in one of their rooms or a few rooms, and they provide just bread. They call it bread and breakfast. That's B&B. They provide just breakfast, and there's some other like inns also. They run B&B where they feed you. It is a small tiny room, not so big, but it's comfortable. You'll be able to eat. Some they serve breakfast, lunch and dinner, while some is just breakfast, depend on what the bargain is and what the person wants. And some have their flat and maybe they have extra rooms, and maybe their children or other people have moved out and they just have the room to spare, so they rent it out. They only provide breakfast, while some, they don't even like most of them will provide breakfast for you. They just your breakfast. You can, some can either you cook, because I had one where you had to cook yourself, or you cannot cook. Some will tell you they don't want you to use their kitchen, so that is a B&B. So there's a room share, there's B&B, and there's a flat. The flat is where a house is on top of another house. That means you're not on the floor, you're not alone. Like there's a, is that a one-story building, two-story building, or three, like that. So that is a flat, or a house. A house here is alone, is on the floor. It has either balcony, front garden, or back garden. So you want to be sure, you want to, maybe the cottage or something more classy that you want. So you have to be sure of that. That is where you will be sure to be sure of where you want. If you want the room share, to share a room with someone who maybe owns the main building, then it is very good if you check spare room. Go online, check www.spareroom.co.uk. You're going to get a lot of offers. Sign up and you get alert. Make your offer. When you make your offer, the landlord, they just send a message, they will reply. It is better you check every day. Get, if there's a number there, get the number, call them. Don't wait until they respond to your email. But if there's no number, then you have to be patient. Send them a mail, ask if this room is still available, or you call them, ask if the room is still available, you're very interested. Then the price is usually attached, so you see the price. And be sure, make sure you inquire that there's heating, central heating. If there's no heating in your room, you're going to freeze. In winter, you're going to be so cold. So you need to have, even if you're sharing the flat, it has to be with heating in the room or central heating. And your door should be locked, at least, so you'll be secured. You're not afraid. There are somewhere you have, they're not locked. There's no lock at the back of the door, but if you're comfortable. But if you're not comfortable, it's better you get the one that has the door, the lock at the back of the door, so you'll be safe. Then if it is the flat, you can't move. Check gumtree.com, gumtree.co.uk. check Zoopla also usually have a lot of rooms to rent. You just see that they post every day. Sign up on all these sites before you come into the country, or when you're in the country, sign up, check daily, subscribe for alerts. They will send you alerts for whatever they have. And agents that usually they're into housing, apply to them. They will note your whatever you want down. Then whenever they have maybe houses, they will send, they will either call you, or even when you show any interest, then the day you're going to check the house is going to be an open viewing day. Like, you may be up to 4 or 5 people who are trying to view the same property on the same day. So if you really love the property, make sure you have your money in the account, or you have your money at hand, or you have your deposit, at least something to show. Because, and make sure you know what you're going to say, show your evidence of employment, or show that yes, you can really afford the house, because that's what's going to put you on top of the of your game. They're going to bring you like one of the priority, because they will just tell you, you come and view, and they'll tell you, we'll get back to you at the end of the day, or someone else. Some even at that moment, that spot, they will drop deposit for the house. So it's better if you have your deposit with you, you can drop it immediately. Or if they say they're going to call you back, make sure the way they call you back, you have the money to pay or the deposit to pay. And most likely, I don't think you're going to be duped. But make sure you check the house, check properly, ask questions, go around, be sure that what you want. And usually once you give, you stay for a few months and you give notice of leaving there, you're not supposed to have problem as long as you didn't damage anything. So it's just that easy. The things you need to rent a house, the landlord will ask one or two references, someone to say yes, they trust you, you're going to pay their rent. Some can ask for your employment letter or just evidence, something to show that yes, you're really employed and you can afford the bill. Then they will give you a contract to sign. Make sure you collect your contract. If your house, if you don't have a contract for your house, then I don't know, you should have a contract. They should send, give you a contract that should state what and what is expected of them, what is expected of you, the rent and everything, to show officially that yes, especially if you're bringing your family, you need to have the contract of to say yes, you have a place where you're keeping your family, and to say yes, you're allowed to be in that property. Evidence of address. Then aside the address, you also need deposit. Some will ask for the, if the rent is £500, then the deposit sometimes can be £500, depending on what your landlord wants. You may need the deposit of the same rent you're paying for maybe 1 month, and when you're leaving, they should give you your deposit back, except you have spoiled or damaged anything, or you didn't give them that notice. Most landlords will ask for 1 month notice, so they expect you to tell them when you're leaving, and when you're leaving, they're supposed to give you your deposit back. So finding a house somehow can be very tricky, because you may get a house that is not close to your work, or you may get a house that is close to your work and you don't like it, and you just need to start searching, and you need to take searching for accommodation very seriously, because it can take time. Sometimes you're stranded, you don't get, if you don't have a house, I don't know, you don't want to be homeless in the country, because it's usually very cold. And some other people also, they're eligible for council house are very cheap. Council house, they will give you for a very cheap price, like way cheaper than them. It depends on if you're eligible or you're not eligible. I won't be able to say if everybody's eligible. Depend on your status in the country, depend on your circumstance, depend on your situation, where that's when you'll be able to say yes, you're eligible for a council house. The flats are usually cheaper than the houses, because the flat, you know, is a little bit uncomfortable. Maybe sometimes you have to take the stairs. There are no elevators in most of the buildings, you have to take the staircase. So the flats, sometimes they can be cheaper than the houses. The flats can be 2-bedroom, 3-bedroom, 1-bedroom flats, and they're usually comfortable, just the stress of going up and down. The houses are usually the best, but they're more expensive, because the houses, you can have playing ground outside or some at the back, even garden. It's really beautiful. If you're not planning to stay in the house at the moment, the houses you see, they'll post it, especially on Gumtree or even Rightmove. When they'll post it, even spare room, they'll post it and tell you available maybe 1 month time, available in 2 months. So those are the houses you should be looking at. So they're not keeping the house for you. Show your interest, even if you're going to be needing at that period or in time. If you're needing at that time, show your interest. So even if you need a house in maybe the next 3 months, you can apply for the house now, or you can search for the house now, get it sorted out. And by the time you're moving, some of the houses are furnished, some are not furnished. Even if they say the house is not furnished, try and still go to check, because some landlord, the houses are furnished, but if they write it on the line or state it that it's furnished, even your contract that it is furnished, then they have to go through a lot of check. But some will just tell you it is furnished, but we're not publicizing that it is furnished. But it is better if you are just coming and you're new, it's better advise you to get a furnished house, except you're very rich, or except you're planning to like buy a lot of things, because then you need the bed, you need a chair, you need the tables, you need everything. But if the house is furnished, all you need is your bag and your linen and your beddings and the rest of the things you use. Some are even furnished up to cutlery. Some houses have pots, have, because maybe somebody that stayed there, they didn't need those things and they didn't go with it. So I would advise you, especially if you're new in the country, to get a house that is furnished. And if you have family, it is best to go for a house so the children will not disturb the people down. Because most of the floor is, there's no noise proof at all. People can hear what is happening downstairs or upstairs. So if you're in a house, if you can afford it, it's not compulsory, if you can afford it. I learned there are places in the UK where you can't, if you have family or young children, you can't stay in a flat. But some other places, it's not like that. But just for your own convenience and for the children's convenience, it's better a house. A house, then you have a garden to yourself. If you have animal also, check also if the house is animal free. Some landlords don't want animal in their house. Some landlords don't want smokers. So those are the things you want to check out for. And check, is the house, is the electricity, I mean the heating. Some houses are electric heating, some are gas. You want to check which one is more cheap, which one you want to go for. Gas most time are cheaper. Electricity sometimes, depend on where you're staying. Check the band of the house. Some houses are divided into different band, A, B, C, D. If you're staying in a house that is not, that is band maybe D, when it is winter, then you're going to be very cold and you will need more heating. You're going to spend more on electricity. And because, but if you're staying in a house that is band A, band B, C is still fair, then during, that means those houses, they retain more heat or the windows are double glazed. So when winter comes, it's not so cold and the council tax, the bills also is not that much. They don't bill you more because then you don't need much heating compared to those who are in a house where that does not retain heat. So those are the things you need to check out for before you get a house. And I wish you good luck. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe below. Thank you.